Patient and caregiver teaching. The trans-theoretical model comes from a background of psychotherapy and behavior change. Positive reinforcement of the learner's achievements is critical in making lifestyle changes. Reinforcement of the changes being made is an important nursing intervention. Pre-contemplation is the stage at which there is no intention to change behavior in the foreseeable future. Many individuals in this stage are unaware or underaware of their problems. Contemplation is the stage in which people are aware that a problem exists and are seriously thinking about overcoming it, but have not yet made any commitment to take action. Preparation is the stage that combines intention and behavioral criteria. Individuals in this stage are intending to take action in the next month and have unsuccessfully taken action in the past year. Action is the stage in which individuals modify their behavior, experiences, or environment in order to overcome their problems. Action involves the most overt behavioral change and requires considerable commitment of time and energy. Maintenance is the stage in which people work to prevent relapse and consolidate the gains attained during action. Termination takes on a new self-image. Old behavior is no longer a threat. Teaching learning process. Reading level for patient teaching material should be at the fifth grade level. Do not use too many medical terms. If a patient is illiterate, then avoid the use of written material. The lack of reading ability does not necessarily imply that the family must be included, though, in teaching process. Adults learn best when given information that can be used immediately. Role-playing allows the patient to practice assertive behavior and receive feedback about how the behavior is perceived. Motivation and readiness to learn depend on what the patient values and perceives as important. Learning goals should state clear, measurable outcomes of the learning process. Process of patient teaching. Assessment is the first step in assisting a patient with health changes. Adult learners are independent. The nurse should act as a facilitator for learning rather than as the expert. Adults learn best when the topic is of immediate usefulness. Long-term goals may not be very motivating. Principles of adult education indicate that readiness and motivation to learn are high when facing the new tasks, like diabetes injections or wound care, and when demonstration and practice of skills are available. Adult education is most effective when focused on information that the patient thinks is needed right now. A long-term response may need to be assessed after discharge, and this is where a home health referral would allow this to occur.